The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hello dear children, how are you all? Sugano? എല്ലാവരും കാലത്ത് നേരത്തെ എഴുന്നേൽക്കാൻ തുടങ്ങി അല്ലേ? 7 മണിക്ക് മുന്നേ. ഓക്കെ, ടീച്ചർക്ക് മെസ്സേജ് എല്ലാം കിട്ടുന്നുണ്ട്. ഇതേപോലെ നോട്ട്സ് എല്ലാം കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ചെയ്യണം, വീഡിയോസ് എല്ലാം കാണണം. ഓക്കെ, വീഡിയോസ് എല്ലാം അന്നന്ന് തന്നെ കാണണം. നിങ്ങൾ സ്വാമി വിവേകാനന്ദനെ കുറിച്ച് കേട്ടിട്ടുണ്ടോ? ആധുനിക ഇന്ത്യയുടെ വക്താവ് എന്നായിരുന്നു അദ്ദേഹം അറിയപ്പെട്ടിരുന്നത്. അതായത് നമ്മളുടെ ഭാരത സംസ്കാരത്തെ ലോകത്തിന് മുന്നിൽ തുറന്നു കാട്ടിയ ഒരു മഹാനായ വ്യക്തിയായിരുന്നു സ്വാമി വിവേകാനന്ദൻ. അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ ജന്മദിനമായ ജനുവരി 12 ദേശീയ യുവജന ദിനമായാണ് ആചരിക്കുന്നത്. അദ്ദേഹം ഇന്ത്യയിലെ ഓരോ യുവാക്കളോടും പറഞ്ഞത് ഇതായിരുന്നു, ഉണരൂ, പ്രവർത്തിക്കൂ. മാനവ സേവയാണ് മാധവ സേവ എന്ന് നമ്മെ പഠിപ്പിച്ച സ്വാമിജി. എല്ലാ മനുഷ്യരിലും ഈശ്വരനുണ്ടെന്നും സാധുജന സേവയാണ് ഈശ്വര സേവ എന്നും നമുക്ക് പറഞ്ഞു തന്നു. വളരെ ചെറുപ്പത്തിൽ തന്നെ ആരാവാനാണ് ആഗ്രഹം എന്ന ചോദ്യത്തിന് അദ്ദേഹം ഒരേ ഒരു ഉത്തരമാണ് നൽകിയത്, ഒരു സന്യാസിയാവണം. വളരെ കുട്ടിയായിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ ഒരുപാട് സമയം ധ്യാനത്തിലിരിക്കുക അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ ഒരു ശീലമായിരുന്നു. അതേപോലെ ഒരുപാട് കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഒരേ സമയം ശ്രദ്ധിച്ച് ചെയ്യുവാനുള്ള കഴിവും അദ്ദേഹത്തിനുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. ഭീരുത്വവും കാപട്യവും ദൂരെ കളഞ്ഞ് സത്യത്തെ പിന്തുടരാൻ പഠിപ്പിച്ച സ്വാമിജി അവനവനിൽ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്ന ഒരു വ്യക്തിക്ക് മാത്രമേ ശക്തിയും മഹത്വവും നേടാൻ പറ്റൂ എന്നും കൂടി നമ്മളെ പഠിപ്പിച്ചു. അതായത് സെൽഫ് കോൺഫിഡൻസ്, ആത്മവിശ്വാസം. നരേന്ദ്രനാഥ ദത്ത എന്നായിരുന്നു സ്വാമി വിവേകാനന്ദൻ്റെ യഥാർത്ഥ നാമം. അദ്ദേഹത്തെ എല്ലാവരും നരേൻ എന്നാണ് വിളിച്ചിരുന്നത്. കുട്ടിയായിരുന്ന നരേൻ ഒരു ദിവസം തെരുവിലൂടെ നടന്നു പോകുമ്പോൾ ഒരു വശത്ത് കുറേയധികം ആളുകൾ കൂടി നിന്ന് വല്ലാത്ത ബഹളം കേട്ടു. എന്താണെന്നറിയാൻ അങ്ങോട്ട് ചെന്ന ആ കുട്ടി കണ്ടത് ദൂരെ നിന്നും ശരവേഗത്തിൽ പാഞ്ഞെടുക്കുന്ന ഒരു കുതിരവണ്ടിയും അതിൽ പേടിച്ച് വിറച്ച് അലമുറയിട്ട് കരയുന്ന ഒരു സ്ത്രീയെയുമായിരുന്നു. കടിഞ്ഞാണില്ലാതെ പാഞ്ഞെടുക്കുന്ന ആ കുതിരയെ കണ്ട് ആളുകൾ പകച്ചു നിന്നുപോയി. എന്തു ചെയ്യണം എന്നാർക്കും മനസ്സിലായില്ല. പക്ഷേ ഒന്നും ആലോചിക്കാതെ നരേൻ ആ കുതിരയുടെ കടിഞ്ഞാണിൽ ചാടി പിടിക്കുകയും ആ കുതിരയെ നിയന്ത്രിക്കുകയും ചെയ്തു. അങ്ങനെ ആ സ്ത്രീയുടെ ജീവൻ രക്ഷിച്ചു. അന്ന് ആ കുട്ടിക്ക് അതിന് കഴിഞ്ഞത് അവനിലുള്ള ആത്മവിശ്വാസം ഒന്നുകൊണ്ട് മാത്രമാണ് അല്ലേ? എത്രയോ വലിയ മുതിർന്ന ആളുകൾ അവിടെ ഉണ്ടായിട്ടും അവർക്കൊന്നും ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റാതെ പകച്ചു നിന്ന് പോയപ്പോൾ ആ കുതിരയുടെ കടിഞ്ഞാൻ പിടിച്ചു നിർത്തി ആ കുതിരവണ്ടി നിയന്ത്രണത്തിലാക്കാൻ ഒരു കുട്ടിക്ക് കഴിയണമെങ്കിൽ അത് തന്നിലുള്ള ഒരു ആത്മവിശ്വാസം കൊണ്ട് മാത്രമാണ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് മക്കളെ, അവനവനിൽ വിശ്വസിക്കുക, തൻ്റെ കഴിവിൽ വിശ്വസിക്കുക, എങ്കിൽ മാത്രമേ നമുക്ക് ജീവിതത്തിൽ വിജയം നേടാൻ പറ്റൂ. സോ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, വി ക്യാൻ കണ്ടിന്യൂ അവർ ചാപ്റ്റർ ഇൻസൈഡ് നമ്പേഴ്സ്. ഇൻ ലാസ്റ്റ് ക്ലാസ് വി ഓൾറെഡി ഡിസ്കസ്ഡ് അബൌട്ട് ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ്, ഇസ്ന്റ് ഇറ്റ്? സോ ടുഡേ വി ക്യാൻ കണ്ടിന്യൂ ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ് ബൈ ഡൂയിങ് സം പ്രോബ്ലംസ്. ഫ്രം ദ ഗിവൺ നമ്പേഴ്സ്, ക്യാൻ യു പിക്ക് ഔട്ട് ദ നമ്പേഴ്സ് ഫോർ വിച്ച് 10 ഇസ് എ ഫാക്ടർ, ഫോർ വിച്ച് 5 ഇസ് എ ഫാക്ടർ, ആൻഡ് ഫോർ ദ നമ്പേഴ്സ് ഫോർ വിച്ച് 2 ഇസ് എ ഫാക്ടർ. ഹിയർ വി ക്യാൻ സി ദ നമ്പേഴ്സ് ഫോർ വിച്ച് 10 ഇസ് എ ഫാക്ടർ ആർ 50, 40, 70, 20 ആൻഡ് 10, ഇസ്ന്റ് ഇറ്റ്? What about the numbers for which 5 is a factor? Yes, we can see the numbers 50, 45, 40, 25, 70, 20, 10 and 5. Now we can move to the numbers for which 2 is a factor. Here the numbers are 50, 18, 40, 28, 14, 70, 12, 20, 6, 8 and 10. That means here you can see the numbers as multiples of 10, as multiples of 5 and the numbers which are multiples of 2. Can you find out any peculiarity in these numbers? Yes. When we take the multiples of 10, we can see all the multiples have 0 in ones place, isn't it? What about the numbers which are multiples of 5? In multiples of 5, we can see in that numbers ones place, the numbers are 0 and 5 repeated. What about multiples of 2? In multiples of 2, we can see in ones place, the numbers are even numbers. Now, shall we check about the multiples of 3, that is the numbers for which 3 is a factor? Here the numbers are 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30, etc. What are the peculiarities of these numbers? Can you say any peculiarity? Here, when we take the sum of the digits in each number, we can see all the digit sum are multiples of 3, isn't it? Now, what about these numbers, that is multiples of 9? Here you can see the numbers 9, 18, 27, 36, 45, 54, then 63, 72, 81, 90, etc. Here you can see when we take the sum of the digits in each number, all numbers are 9, isn't it? That means we can conclude by saying that for the numbers which are multiples of 3, their digital roots are multiples of 3. Similarly, for the numbers which are multiples of 9 also, we can see their digital roots are multiples of 9. So we can conclude again by saying in multiples of 2, we can see even numbers in ones place. In multiples of 5, we can see 5 or 0 in ones place. In multiples of 10, we can see 0 in ones place. And in multiples of 3, the digital roots of each number is multiple of 3. Similarly, in multiples of 9, the digital root of each number is multiple of 9. Understood? Now we can move to a new topic, which is composite and prime. Here you can see a number 13. Can you say what are the factors of 13? Yes. 13 is divisible by 1 and 13 is also divisible by 30, isn't it? So we can say the factors of 13 are 1 and 30. Now, what about the number 7? Here for 7, we can say the factors are 1 and 7. Now, we can take another example, 11. What are the factors of 11? Yes, the factors of 11 are 1 and 11. So, here for these numbers, we can see the factors are 1 and the number itself, isn't it? So, these type of numbers are called prime numbers. Understood? Now, we can take another number 4. What about the factors of 4? Here, the factors of 4 are 1, 2 and 4, isn't it? What about this number 12? Here, for 12, the factors are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. So, here, for these numbers 4 and 12, we can see so many factors, isn't it? So, these type of numbers are called composite numbers. So, dear children, can you find out prime numbers between 1 and 50? So, here first we can write the numbers from 1 to 50. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. Here, we can see 1. 1 has only one factor, that is 1 itself, isn't it? So, we can say 1 is neither prime nor composite. Now, we can take next number 2. 2 is prime because 2 has only two factors, 1 and 2. So, what about the multiples of 2? Multiples of 2 are composite numbers, isn't it? So, we can take multiples of 2, that is 4, 6, then 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30. Similarly, 32, 34, 36, 38, 40. Here, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50. So, we can see all the multiples of 2 are composite numbers. Now, we can take the next number 3. 3 is a prime number, isn't it? What about the multiples of 3? When we take multiples of 3, all multiples are composite numbers. So, 9, 6 already we taken, 9 is composite, 12, then 15, 18, then 21, 24, 27, 30, the next is 33, next 36, next 39, then 42, 45, then the next number is 48. So, all the multiples of 3 are composite numbers. Now, we can move to the next number 5. 5 is a prime number, isn't it? What about the multiples of 5? 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Now, the next one is 7. 7 is prime. What about multiples of 7? 14, next is 21, next 28, then 35, then 42, we already taken, isn't it? Next is 49. These are composite numbers. Now, the next is 11. So, 11 is prime number and multiples of 11 are composite numbers. Here, we can see 22. Then 33, 44, these are multiples of 11. Next is 13. 13 is prime. And multiples of 13, we can take 26, the first one. Next is 39. Next is 52. Now, the next is 17. 17 is prime. Multiple of 17 means the first number is 34. It is composite. Now, the next 19, multiple of 19, 38, it is composite. Now, the next is
23. Next one, 29. Next, 31. Now, 37. Then, the next is 41, 43, 47. So, these numbers are prime numbers between 1 and 50. 2, 3, 5, 7, then 11, 13, 17, then 19, then 23, then 29, next is 31, next 37, then 41, 43 and 47. So these numbers are prime numbers between 1 to 50. So we can see there are 15 prime numbers between 1 and 50. We can move to a new topic, which is prime factors. How can we write 10 as the product of factors? We can write 10 as 1 into 10 and 2 into 5, isn't it? So here we can see the factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5 and 10. What about the number 30? How can we write the factors of 30? Here 30 means 1 into 30, then 2 into 15, then 3 into 10, then 5 into 6. So here the factors of 30 are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. Now here, how can we find out the prime factors of 10? For that, we have to write the 10 first, then we can take prime numbers for which the multiple is 10. Here we can see 2 and 5 are prime numbers, isn't it? So 2 into 5 is 10. That means the prime factors of 10 are 2 and 5. Now, what about 30? How can we find out the prime factors of 30? Here, when we take 30 as a multiple of 5 and 6, 5 is a prime number, but 6 is not prime, isn't it? It is composite. Here, these numbers also, 2 is prime, 15 is composite, 3 is prime, 10 is composite. So, we have to write this 30 as the product of prime numbers. So, when we take 5 into 6, we can write this 6 as 2, 3s are 6. 2 and 3 are prime numbers. So, 2 into 3. That means 5 into 2 into 3 is 30. So, here these three numbers are prime numbers. So, prime factors of 30 are 2, 3 and 5. Understood? Now we can check the prime factors of a number 24 and we can find out the prime factors using tree diagram. So here 24 means we can take the first prime number, which is 2. 24 is multiple of 2, isn't it? 2 into 12 is 24. So here the first number 2, the next one is here 12. 2 into 12 is 24. Now this 12 is composite, so we can take 12 and we can take the first prime number 2. 2, 6 are 12. So again here 2, here 6. Now 6 is composite. The factors of 6 are 2, 3s are 6. So 2 into 3. So now we got all prime factors of this 24. Here 3 is prime number. So the prime factors of 24 are 2, 2, 2, 3. That means 24 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. So the prime factors are 2, 2, 2 and 3.
Now how can we find out the prime factors of 32 like this? That is using tree diagram. 32 we can write as multiple of 2 into 16, isn't it? So first one 2, next one is 16. Now 2 is prime but 16 is composite. So we have to take 16. 16 means it is 2 into 8. 2 8s are 16. Now we can take 8 here. 8 means 2 into 4. Now the next is 4. We can take 4 as 2 into 2. Now we got all prime factors. That means 32 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 5 2s are there. So the prime factors of 32 are 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay. Now we can move to another topic, which is basic factors. So here we used tree diagram to find out the prime factors of some numbers, isn't it? If the numbers are large numbers, how can we find out prime factors? For that, we have to use division method. So we can do the first problem, which is 252. So here the question is, what are the prime factors of 252? Here we use the division method. So first we have to divide this number with the least prime number. So here 2 is the least prime number, and here we can see even number in ones place. That means 252 is divisible by 2. So we can divide the number with 2. 1 2 is 2, next number is 5. So 2 2s are 4. There will be remainder 1, isn't it? So that number we have to take together, so it is 12. That means 6 2s are 12. Again we have to divide. Here also we can see this number is divisible by 2 because 6 is an even number. When we divide this 126 with 2, we can see 6 2s are 12. Next is 6, 3 2s are 6. What about 63? Can we divide this 63 with 2? No, it's not possible, isn't it? Because 3 is an odd number. But when we take the next prime number 3, 63 is divisible by 3 because the digital root of 63 is 6 plus 3, 9. And 9 is divisible by 3, isn't it? So we can take 3 here. So 2 3s are 6, 1 3 is 3. The next one is 21. This 21 also we can divide with 3 because its digital root is 3. So the next is 7. Now you can see 7 is prime number, so we can stop here. So here 252 we can write as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7. That means the prime factors are 2, 2, 3, 3 and 7. Okay. Now we can find out prime factors of 145. Here we can take division method. So 145. Here this number is not divisible by 2 because 5 is odd number. And this number is not divisible by 3 because 1 plus 4 plus 5, it is 10. It is not a multiple of 3. And the next we can take, the next prime number we can take is 5. This number is divisible by 5 because in ones place we can see 5, isn't it? And here 2 5s are 10. Balance 4 we can take with 5, so 45. 9 5s are 45. Now, can we divide this 29 with any prime number? Is it possible? No, because 29 is prime number, isn't it? So we can take 145 as 5 into 29. So the prime factors are
5.29.
Now the next topic is highest common factor. What are the factors of 16? We can find out the factors of 16 as 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16, isn't it? Now, what about 12? The factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Here we can see the common factors for 16 and 12 as 1, 2 and 4. So, the common factors are 1, 2 and 4. Which is the largest factor here? Yes, it is 4. So, we can write the highest common factor of 12 and 16 as 4. Now, we can find out this highest common factor using the division method. For that, first we can find out the prime factors of 16. So, we can divide 16 with 2, 8 2s are 16, again with 2, 4 2s are 8, now again with 2, 2 2s are 4. That means we can write 16 as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Now the next number is 12. When we divide 12 with 2, we will get 6. Next again 2, 3 2s are 6. So 12 is 2 into 2 into 3. Here we can see the common prime factors are 2 2s. 2 is common, this 2 is also common. So, when we take these 2 2s, we can write the highest common factor as 2 into 2. 2 into 2 is 4. Understood? 2 is, 1 2 is common here. Next, another 2. That means 2 into 2 is the highest common factor. 2 into 2 is 4. Now, we can find out the highest common factor for the numbers 24 and 18. 24, 18. So, here we can use division method. So, when we divide this 24, we can take 2. So, 12 2s are 24. Again, dividing with 2, 6 2s are 12. Again, with 2, 3 2s are 6. So, we can write 24 as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Now, we can take 18. We can divide 18 with 2. 9 2s are 18. Next with the 3. Because 9 is not divisible by 2. 3 3s are 9. So, we can stop here. So, 18 is 2 into 3 into 3. Here we can see 2. 1 2 is common here. And here 3 is also common. 1 3 is also common factor. So, 2 and here 3 are the common factors for 24 and 18. So, here the highest common factor we can find out by taking this 1, 2 and 1, 3. That means 2 into 3, which is 6. So, the highest common factor of 24 and 18 is 6. So, dear children, we can wind up today's class and you can do the homework problems and you can practice these problems at home. Okay. So, practice well and you have to watch videos daily and you have to complete your works properly. Okay. So, see you in the next class. Take care. Bye.